Welcome, folks, to the first game here on September 11th, 2016, between the Reading Rockets and the Wilmington Wildcats. It's a beautiful day, actually, here now in Reading. About a nice 75 degrees, partly cloudy with a little bit of wind coming out of the north. The Rockets will, and Wilmington will line up for the coin toss. Today's captains for Reading are number 11, Troy Pollock, number 22, Dan Damari, number 32, Dom DiCrescenzo, and number 24, Lucas Lorenza. It looks like Reading has won the toss, and it looks like they've elected to defer, as Wilmington will receive. And that's it. We'll be back with kickoff action in a moment. All right, folks, we got Reading ready to kick off. Ready on the right, ready on the left. And the boot is a squib kicker. And Wilmington recovers on the ground. I'm not sure if that was designed that way. Maybe it was. But nonetheless, we're going to have first and 10 for Wilmington on their own 42. Okay, first and 10 for the Wilmington Wildcats as they come out in what looks to be a wishbone formation. They're gonna go with a power to the right, and great play by number, looked like, I couldn't tell who that was. I don't know if you could see that, Joe.
I didn't get him either.
20 something, 24 maybe, I'm not sure. But nonetheless, excellent play by the defensive lineman for the Reading Rockets. As Wilmington, yep, comes up to the line. There's a loss of about four on the play. Wilmington comes back out in the wishbone. Don't see the wishbone too often. Fullback up the middle. And
I see O'Connor in there.
Reading stopped. Number 22, Dan Damari on the stop.
Number 54 is in there as well.
Number 54. 64? Okay. Wilmington comes back up to the ball. Third and long, a third and 12. They're going to give it to the fullback, who's swarmed by the Reading Rocket defense again. Number 9, Jay
Kajander
was in on that play. Looks like he's your right end, along with number 81, and Zach Kenyon.
And Lucas Lorenza
in on the play. So it's going to come right off the gate. Wilmington's in a tough situation. Fourth and long, fourth and 11. They're at their own 41-yard line. They're running a wishbone, so I don't know what their passing ability is. Looks like they're going to try to punt the ball here.
Troy Pollock is back.
Yep, number 11, Troy Pollock, deep. It's a good boot, good kick. Pollock is under it. He's able to get it, and he's brought down.
46.
Still inside the Rocket territory at the 46, where they'll take over first and 10. Yeah, the Reading Rockets come out on offense.
We got Pat Dwyer split out to the right wide. We got Lucas Fleming receiving the snap, Brian.
Yep. And number 23, yep, Lucas Fleming on the run.
Big physical back.
Yep, he's got some room. He's making some room. And he's going to take it for a touchdown on the opening drive. Reading.
Lucas has a good combination of speed and power.
Speed and power,
he's
yeah.
He's tough to put down. When he gets in the open field, he's tough to catch.
He looked it on that play, boy. I mean, the offensive line looked like they did a good job, but boy, he just, a lot of it was done by himself. So excellent job for Reading as they go up 6-0. Catch, I remember him. Jesus. All right, Reading's going to come out for the extra point. And it looks like they're going to go for two on this as they line up in the shotgun. Number 41 is going to take it himself. Number 41, Beckenhouse, is going to take it, and he's in for the extra try. So okay, so it is one. Okay, so at the end of the minutes left in the first, we've got Reading 7, Wilmington 0. All right, Reading set to kick off. Number 23, Lucas Fleming, going to kick. This time he's going to try to go deep. Gives it a good boot, but it looks like it's going to sail out of bounds, and it does, which will be a penalty on Reading. I believe that puts the ball at the 35 or 40. I haven't seen a kickoff go out of bounds in a little while, so I'm not sure of the ruling. But the referee is going to tell us right now. And it is the, yeah, it's going to be the 35 is where the Wilmington will start the ball. Okay, correction on that. The penalty goes to the 30-yard line where the Wilmington Wildcats will take over. Again, in the wishbone, they're going to go right up the middle. And again, nothing doing. That Reading Rocket defense right now is playing outstanding.
Yeah, they're a tough defense, Brian. They got a lot of speed. They're very aggressive.
You got good size on the line.
Yeah. They're not huge, but good enough, and they've got a lot of speed out there.
Yeah. Now we got an offsides, though, so that's going to give Wilmington 5 yards. We'll remain first down. The other day. Whew. Wilmington, first and 5 now after the penalty. They're going to go with the fullback trap up the middle, but Reading is not fooled. In fact, I thought the ball was on the ground there for a minute. Wasn't. That left side of the defensive line is really doing a great job. Number 54, Dan O'Connor out there. Number 32, Dom DiCosenzo.
Yes, I see Sean Beckenhouse trailing, making sure he doesn't cut back.
Yeah.
It's a good swarming defense. It was last year. And they continue.
Number 73, Patrick Duros, playing in a linebacker position out there, doing a good job. As Wilmington will come up, second and about 8-7. They're going to try to pass here, and they got a man
Pollock's
deep.
Got him.
And I believe he caught that. Now, that's an outstanding play by Wilmington. Great catch. Number 11, Troy Pollock, was in coverage. But the Wilmington receiver was able to get his hands up and bring the ball
catch.
Down.
Good
excellent.
Coverage. Just
great catch, great coverage, but he just got the better of him that time. But nonetheless, it gives the Wildcats a first down. They're inside of Rocket territory now at the 47-yard line. And the quarterback's going to try to keep it himself. He's got nothing going, nothing at all. Tried to turn back, number 24, Lucas Lorenzo was there to stop him. Number 9, Jay Kanger?
It's Kanger.
Kanger was there.
And David Lynch going to
yep,
the game.
Number 10, David Lynch checking in at left tackle. Wilmington coming up to the line. Got a second and long, second and 10. Where they're going to try a counter play. And it does prove effective to give Wilmington about 7 yards, 6 or 7 yards on the play. The Reading Rockets looked like they were a little bit fooled on that defense, which is what that play is designed to do. So it'll bring up third down and about 4 for the first down. Wilmington set to snap it. They go with the QB sneak, but it looks like there was a false start on that. I got a feeling that's coming back, Joe.
Yeah, I think you're right. That's a good penalty for the Rockets.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
I think with the speed on the defense, these guys are trying to get a quick start, and I think that's what happened there.
Yeah.
You got Brendan Fox going in. He's a force in the middle. Don't be fooled. He's not a big guy, but he's tough. He'll clog that middle very successfully.
Good. Number 20, Brendan Fox, checking in.
Good to see David Lynch out there, too. He got nicked in the last scrimmage. And
oh, yeah?
Yeah, just good to see him healthy.
And Wilmington here he is going to try to go off a little power play. They get a couple back. They got back almost to where they were before the penalty, so it looks like they got 4 or 5 back on that. But it's going to bring up...
It's second and 5.
I thought it was third down.
It's got to be third.
I thought it was third down. Yeah, it's got to be third. So third down.
Is O'Connor
no, fourth down. Okay, it is fourth down. I was mistaken on that, too. Yeah.
O'Connor back in the game for Brendan Fox.
O'Connor checked back in. Okay. Big fourth down. Wilmington's going to test them. They're going to go for it. They're going to push it. See what they do here. And they're going to try and trap it. Whoa, baby. Big defense.
Looks like David Lynch.
I would say that was number
32.
That was number 32. That was number Dom DiCrescenzo.
Yeah, Dom's big boy.
With a big play right there to stop them.
And he's a good athlete. Yeah. He'll make plenty of those tackles this year.
Good to see it. Redding takes over, first and 10. Boy, you pop him. All right. Redding takes over, first and 10. They are inside their own territory at about the 41-yard line. The pitch play is going to go back to number 32. Dom. I'm sorry, number 23, Lucas.
I think you had it right.
32. No, it was. I'm sorry. It was DiCrescenzo, number 32.
A little bit of a power running
it game. It was a power, point. Yes.
It was Damari in for DiLorenzo.
It's number 22, Dan Damari checks in.
Dan's a good combination of speed and power.
Yeah.
Similar to Lucas Fleming.
Yeah. Redding's running it. Looks like a... there you go, Dan. Dan's got some nice blocking outside.
First down. I like it.
That is a first down. I mean, the right side of the offensive line did a great job in opening up the hole for Dan. You know, and that's obviously what you need at this level is a lot of blocking. Well, on any level, really. But
yeah, and like I said, these kids, they're good athletes back there. If you give them a hole, they're gonna find it.
Looks like we've got number 20, Brendan Fox, on the line. Don't have a good enough angle to see the rest of them now, but...
Yeah, Pat Dwyer.
Number
split
71
out to the right
split
again.
Out. Yep, Dwyer. They're going to go with Damari again. Damari gets hit, but was able to continue on forward to get himself another yard after the pop. So he's going to pick up about 4 yards on the play. We've got number 43, Max Romos, on the offensive line. Number 50, Logan Futura. And forgive me if I'm mispronouncing
these names. I think it's Fortuna.
Fortuna on the line. And looks like we've got now back under center, number 11, Troy Pollock.
He is quick.
He's got some room on the outside. He's got plenty of room on the outside. Nice job. Touchdown, number 11, Troy Pollock. Excuse me. With some, again, great blocking by the offense on the outside of the line. Left side of the line, excuse me, and it's enough to enable Pollock to get in there for the first down. So Reading, 13, Wilmington, nothing. All right, Reading's going to line up for the extra point attempt, and number 11, Pollock, is going to take it himself. He has plenty of room to get through there, and he does.
Huge hole. That offensive line.
Offensive line is really doing a great job. So we've got... with about 2 minutes left in the first quarter, we've got Reading 14, Wilmington 0. Lined up to kick off, number 23, Lucas Fleming, will be doing the honors again. Good high kick, end over end, taken at the 27 by Wilmington, and brought down after a run of about 5 yards by the Reading special teams. First and 10, Wilmington. Okay, Wilmington, after the changing sides there as we enter the second quarter, Wilmington will go first 10. They're going to drop back and pass. They got a man open. Good attempt, but the Reading was there on the coverage to break up the play. Number 11, Troy Pollock, was back there. Number 44, Sean... Needham?
Stephen Needham.
Stephen Needham. And number 52?
They used to call Stephen Needham the fridge, but he's thinned out and he's become very athletic.
The fridge, huh?
Yeah, he used to play a defensive line and he was excellent. Now they've got him back there.
Wilmington comes back in the wishbone. The fake. Quarterback scrambling. He's in trouble. He's going to try to find his way, and he does, but he's ultimately brought down on a solo tackle by number 8, Trevor Conroy. So good play there. It's going to bring up, I thought it would be third down.
I think it is.
Yeah, I think it's third down. I think we've got third and five. Looks like the chains might not be there. So on the Reading defensive line, we've got number 73, Patrick Duross. Number 50.
That's Logan Fortuna.
54.
That's the 33, Joe Gilligan. Joe Awesome Gilligan.
Yep, Joe Gilligan, number 33. And Wilmington's going to drop back to pass.
Good
quarterback's
pressure.
Looking for some room. He's getting chased. He's trying to get it, but he does a good job of getting the
first down. Yeah, nice job.
Nice little scramble there. It's going to bring up first down for Wilmington. Who's number? Okay. Wilmington comes up right at the 50-yard line, dead midfield. And the give is to the fullback. He's trying to stretch it out, and he's got some room outside. Number 84, Evan Theus.
Evan Theus, yeah, he's
on the play.
Evan's fast.
Nice solo tackle.
You're not going to outrun him.
Good play in the end. It wasn't up for the first down for Wilmington, however. So the chains will move as Wilmington advances even more into Reading territory. The Rockets running what appears to be a 5-3 defense. Maybe a 5-2, depending on how they do it, but fullback up the middle. He's able to get a few on play. As the ball will be spotted at the 32-yard line for Wilmington.
Second and I'd say six, Brian.
So I got six, second and about six.
Should be a big stop for Reading, statement.
Yep. And the quarterback, the fullback, the number 22 for the Wilmington Wildcats had a nice little run inside. Good blocking by his line. He was ultimately brought down after the first down and a pickup of about maybe 12 or 13 yards on the play. So they will remain in first down. Wilmington. Oh, okay. Wilmington back to the line of scrimmage. Back to their tailback, who's got some room along the outside. Going for the end zone. And he's able to get in there for the touchdown. So Wilmington puts some points on the board. As we've got 6-0 with about 5 minutes or so left in the half. 6-14 with about 5 minutes left. All right.
I'm trying to kick here, Brian. That's 2 points in
this
Pop
is
Warner.
2 points in Pop Warner, so it's good to see Wilmington try to go for it. They must be confident in their kicking game. Yeah. It's a high snap. He's going to have to run it. He's looking for a throw.
Ball.
Ball's down.
Run that back.
Yeah, and that's going to be that. So ball falls dead, and score will remain Reading 14, Wilmington 6. Okay, Reading. Comes up to the line of scrimmage. Number 11, Troy Pollock at quarterback. Three receiver set. Number 84, Evan Theus in motion. The fake is to the quarterback, and Pollock takes it himself, and the defender for Wilmington does a great job. Pollock is not easy to take down. And that defender for Wilmington did a great job of taking his legs out. But it was after about an 8-yard gain, about an 8-yard gain by Pollock. So you've got Reading second and about two at their own 49-yard line. Rockets will come out in a three-receiver set. Fullback offset to the quarterback. And it is a keep again by Pollock, who makes a nice move getting some great blocking, outstanding blocking.
He just won't go down, Brian.
And, you know, he breaks about three or four tackles by himself, in which case he's going to, you know, he brings it down well inside of Wilmington's territory, right down to about the 23-yard line, where Reading will remain first and 10. Yeah. You need the right.
All right, Brian, here they go. Let's see. Yep. I think you say that outside running, maybe they pounded up the middle a little.
Well, that run is working effectively.
Yeah, they're a speed team.
It looks like
no
they're going to go back to it.
Oh,
a little quick pass. He's wide open. Nice play. He's got some room on the outside. Nice play. That was number 44, Stephen Needham. Nice catch. Nice dodge. Nice pitch by Pollock. And it's going to move the chains. It gets about 3 or 4 yards out of the play. Second and about six. Okay, Reading comes up the line of scrimmage again in their three receiver set. Ball is snapped. It's the give is to number 22.
That would be Dan Damari.
Yeah, number 22, Dan Damari. Again, this offensive line really doing a great job.
And switching him out, Brian, isn't it?
Now you've got a different offense coming in, it looks like.
Nice fresh team.
Fresh legs for a first down.
I think that Wilmington team might be getting a little tired, the bodies.
I think so. Well, they're giving them all kinds of different looks. They're going inside, outside, up
making
the middle.
Making
them
run.
Yep. Like they've got three receiver set. This time, the tailback got motion with the give to number 23, who's into the end zone.
Lucas Fleming.
Really wasn't even touched there. You know, I don't know if that was, well, it was. It was just outstanding blocking again by the Reading offensive line.
Yeah, Lucas is very patient, waited for that hole to open.
Yeah.
Once he got through
he
it,
just
goodbye.
Made a nice little move and got in there. So a nice run, offensive play by the Reading Rockets as we'd number 11, Troy Pollock comes in. And looks like the Rockets are probably gonna run it. They don't kick. After for the extra point, do they much?
No, they've played with it.
Not really.
I just think they're, especially the way they're moving the ball, they're comfortable doing this.
Yeah. Stick with what's working. And it's going to be a pass, which is fault knocked incomplete.
Let's get the cheerleaders over here.
Yeah, I just wanted to
work hard.
Just give a shout out here to the Reading Rocket cheerleaders. These girls down here supporting their team, doing a fine job as always. It's great to see the support, get the fans in the stands going. And we thank them for all that they do. So, with the Reading Rockets just putting another one into the end zone, the score is Reading 20, Wilmington 6, with about 2 minutes left in the first half. Reading will line up again to kick off. Number 23, Fleming doing the honors. Ball's down, and Wilmington will sit on it as it falls down right around Wilmington's 35, where they will go first and 10. Wilmington comes to the line, fumbled on the snap. Quarterback will just fall on it wisely. Bring up a second down for the Wilmington Wildcats. Gonna try to get something going here. They got about 2 minutes, a little less than 2 minutes, to try to punch one in before the end of the half. As they come up to the line of scrimmage. Quarterback gonna try to keep it himself. He's looking for some room. And great job on the outside. Looked like number 44, Stephen Needham, was there.
He's having a game.
Certainly is. Called on the play. Number 70, big number 70.
Peter Mirigiannis.
Peter Mirigiannis checking in.
And I hope I pronounced that right, Peter.
I hope I did too, but I just took your... I followed you, Joe, so... let's see. We got third down, 9 yards, about 8 yards to go for Wilmington. They got a motion fullback set. They're going to give it back to the fullback, who is once again met.
Big pile.
After about maybe 2 yard gain on the play. And this clock is ticking down. I see no intention by Wilmington to stop it. I believe they have their timeouts. I'm not sure that they used.
Looks like the clock is running.
All of them. I'm surprised Wilmington's.
Yeah, I think they might be happy just going to the locker room.
Not trying to do it, but yeah, maybe that's it.
Turn the ball over down here.
So they're going to try to quarterback keep. And he doesn't want to go down. Good effort by him. But he is stopped short of the first down.
Yeah, that's the end of the quarter.
And that's the end of the half. So score remains as it was not too long ago. 20, Reading Rockets 20, Wilmington 6. We'll catch you for second half action. All right, folks, as we start the second half, Wilmington will be kicking off to Reading.
Onside kick.
And
smart, just bouncing on.
Yep,
that.
That's it. Reading will.
It's like Trevor Conroy.
Reading will fall down on it, take over on downs, where it'll be first and 10 at their own 40-yard line. All right, so Reading will come back out in a one receiver set wide, which is Pat Dwyer. And Reading will run for a few, maybe about a yard and a half, where it will be second and about 9 for the Rockets. The quarterback keep is to number, is that 11? Is that Tripolik again? No, number 41.
Sean Beckenhouse.
Sean Beckenhouse. Keeps the ball. Picks up about 4 on the play for third down 5. Number 32, Dom DiCrescenzo checks in as Beckenhouse checks out. The give is to DiCrescenzo, who runs hard for a few.
Good first down, just move that ball.
Yeah, first down. Dom is going to run over about 3 or 4 people. He's got the size for it.
It's not a very big team, Brian, but the kids who are big have decent speed and they're good athletes.
Yeah, definitely, yeah. And comes back out, back again to number 32, DiCrescenzo, who's going to truck ahead for a few. Carried about 4 or 5 Wilmington defenders with him. So we got the cowbell in the stands going. So Reading now has a second and...
I got a 2.5.
Yeah. Second and 2.
Totally new, 11 new players, I believe, Brian. That's the luxury of having a big roster.
Yes, and a comfortable lead.
Yes, yes.
Number 84, split wide, which which is Evan Theus. The ball is carried for a first down for the Reading Rockets. Cheerleaders again. Getting the fans in the stands wild up.
Turned into a beautiful day, Brian.
Yeah, really nice day. Number 11, Pollock at quarterback. He's going to give it to number 22, Dan Damari, with some good speed and some outstanding blocking by the offensive line and his blocking backs off the left side. And that is enough to move the chains once again. They're really doing a good job here.
It's the perfect drive, Brian.
Yeah.
Just eating some clock, just
yeah.
Get the first downs.
That's it.
It'd be perfect to score and get to be a huge lead.
Number 84, Theus, split wide right. Number 8. Trevor Conroy split wide left with number 44, Stephen Needham, in motion. The give is to number 22, Damari, who's met behind the line of scrimmage, trying to fight ahead. And he leans forward to get back to about the line of scrimmage where, no, I apologize, it was a loss on the play. Loss of about 5 on that play, and
I'm not sure
it's going to be timeout Reading.
Okay. All right, Brian.
Rockets come out in a second and deep. Haven't been in this position for a while. So let's see what they can do. We're talking about second and 15. As they, Pollock is going to roll out, and he finds a wide open number 44. That is number 44, Sean Needham, who... really did a great job by Pollock coming back, just getting rid of the ball quick. Found Needham in the flat, hit him, and he essentially was able to just walk right in there. So
Troy has such good instincts out there. It's just
yeah, he's a good football player.
Yeah,
no
he really
question.
Is good football player. It's perfectly put. Good
so
athlete. But
Reading
really
now goes up by another 6 points as. They will go out for the point after attempt. Am I missing? Did he step out of bounds?
Well, that's the extra point, I believe, Brian.
No, wait a minute.
No, he might have.
No, he must have stepped out of
yeah.
bounds. Yeah.
Missed it myself.
So there goes Pollock. Trying to get in, he did now.
They just wanted one more play, man.
That's it. They just wanted another play. So, Reading is now 26. Wilmington 6. As they will try to come up to the line of scrimmage. All right, Reading's going to come after by the point after attempt. As number
24,
big number 24 gets in.
It's Lucas Lorenzo
for the extra point. And Reading will
multiple
go up.
Multiple weapons.
27-6. All right, Reading will kick off again. It's a bouncing ball to Wilmington. Boy, he's got some size out there. And Wilmington will take over on downs. Wilmington comes up to the line of scrimmage in their typical wishbone formation. And the quarterback's going to try to keep it, but boy, big number. Who was that? Number 71? 73.
Pat Duras.
That was Duras. Big Pat Duras out there making a play in the backfield. Pat Duras has got some good size, and he used it on that play. Loss of about 11 on the play. So it'll be second and 21. And it's a toss sweep. He's going to keep it. He's got some room, but he's ultimately brought down in the backfield by number 84, Evan Theus. Great play. So number Joe Gilligan, number 33, Brandon Fox, number 20, checking out. Number 65, Anthony Masucci, checking out. Get a little breather after their hard work and good efforts. Quarterback is back. He's going to go to the air. What a catch. Excellent catch by Wilmington. Had about three defenders on him, Joe. And just got his hands up there and made a great play.
Once again, you can't fault the defense. Good coverage.
And, you know, that's enough to move the chain. So Wilmington's coming.
Big play.
Coming to life here.
You got to give the kid credit. He made a great catch.
Oh, excellent catch. Wildcats line up first and 10 at Redding's 45. It's a toss sweep left, but Redding is not fooled at all. Is that number 84 back there on the tackle? Or 54? I think it was 84. Evan Theus was the first one to lay a hat on him and stop him to allow for the rest of the Redding defenders to come in and make a play. Wildcats, once again, ground attack for about three on the play. Check that, about two. So it's going to be third down and about 8 yards to go. Quarterback keeps the ball. Moves up for about a yard. Personnel shift for the Redding Rockets. Number 43, Max Romo's coming in. Number 51, Giancarlo Musto checking in. And
I thought I saw Jonathan Grady going in at number 14.
Jonathan Grady, yep. Fourth down and 5 for the Wilmington Wildcats as they're going to try to get the first, but they're going to be stopped short. They're going to be stopped well short of the first down marker, giving the Redding Rockets another opportunity with the ball. All right. So let's see, the Rockets get the ball at the beginning of the fourth quarter with the score 27 Redding, 6 Wilmington.
Ouch.
They're going to give the ball up the middle to, I did not see. Let's see who comes up off the ground. Like maybe number 23, Lucas Fleming.
That's likely Lucas Fleming.
As I think it's fair to say that the Rockets will play a pretty straight north-south game at this point. Just try to chew down that clock a little bit. As it looks like they are. Number 23.
That's Lucas Fleming.
Lucas Fleming again on the carry. Gets about 8 yards on the play, 9 yards on the play. And it is enough for a first down as it'll move the chains for the Rockets. As you were saying, these these Reading Rockets really do have a good size squad as far as their numbers. It's got to be what, almost 30 kids? 20
something? I think there's 30, and then maybe only 28 suited today.
28, okay. Real good numbers.
It's a good roster, and they're deep. A lot of good athletes.
And Pollock is going to go back and pass, and he's got a wide open number 32, Dom DiCrescenza, but just wasn't able to hold on to it. A pretty well-thrown ball, but nonetheless, it falls incomplete. As the Rockets will now have it, I thought it was third down.
It's like third and 10.
Well, the chain down marker still says second. I believe it's third down and 10 for the Rockets. About 8 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Clock does stop because it was an incomplete pass. As the Rockets come out in a three receiver set, two split right, close side near us, one left, far side. Pollock is gonna try to pass it again, but I think he's just gonna decide to run because he's got nobody open, and he does. Keeps the ball inbounds. Gets about seven or eight on the play. And it's gonna be, I think it's fourth down, Joe. I'd say fourth and one.
Fourth and one, yeah.
I think the down marker is off again. Let's see if the Rockets can get at least 3 feet out of this to move the chains again. Same three receiver set. Pollock puts number 81 in motion. Number 23, Fleming, with the carry, and that's going to be a first down for the Rockets. So with about 6 minutes left in the game, Reading finds himself in a first down. Ball. They're on the Wilmington 28 yard line. Pollock is going to try to pass again, and he's got a wide open number 22, Dan Damari, who is able to get into the end zone to make the score now 33-6.
Penalty here, Brian. I heard personal foul number 9. I don't know if it's going to bring it back. It looks like it is.
I believe it is. I didn't see what the penalty was.
I didn't either.
That is a 15-yard penalty, no question about it. So, yes, that'll take back the touchdown. And the Rockets will go back to just about midfield, as they will redo the down, first and 10. Nope, that's only a 10-yard penalty. I apologize.
Might have been from the spot.
Might have been from the spot. You're absolutely right. Yes, it could have been from the spot. I believe that's probably what it was. Yeah, because that's not even 10 yards from the line of scrimmage. Nonetheless, nice throw,
yep.
Nice catch. Nice throw by Pollock, nice catch by Damari.
Yeah, it's good to see they can run
yep.
those plays.
Yep.
It opens it up.
Absolutely.
You'll need those.
Well, Reading will try again. They put number 81 in motion. He's going to try to pass it again, and he does. And this time it does go back to Zach Kenyon for a nice pitch and catch again. Stop short of the first down. So it's going to bring up, I believe it's second down and about 3 yards to go for the first down.
Another mass substitution. It's just good coaching. Keep the kids fresh. Wilmington's got to be really tired at this point. I think they're only suiting 15, 16 boys. And
yes. From a numbers perspective, Reading certainly has the advantage. Number 84, Evan Theus in motion. The give is to, look like 22, Dan Damari, who is brought down in the backfield. Loss of about three or four on the play, where it will remain third down and about six to be able to move the chains. Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage.
Looks like you got Damari Pollock in the backfield.
Yep, number 40, he got a fumble, bad snap. Knee was down, knee must have been down when he picked up the ball because the referee ruled the ball down. Where she's gonna put Rockets in a unfamiliar position with a 4th and 11. Ball is placed at the 35-yard line. Got about 4 minutes left in the game, and Redding's going to take a timeout. All right. After the timeout, Redding breaks the huddle. It's got a fourth down, 11 yards to go. It looks like they're going to go for it here. Ah, the ball is fumbled again. Pollock picks it up. He's trying to get out of there. He's going to pass it. He finds the open man. But, you know, it was real close there. Had he not stepped out of bounds, was that Duras? Had he not stepped out of bounds, he might have been able. Oh, and he does. He does move the chains.
First down.
I apologize. I didn't realize. I thought he stepped out beforehand. Boy, excellent play.
Good
all
play
around.
For both guys. Pollock staying in there, Pollock, making a great throw.
Duras staying catching in the play. It and skipping down the sideline. Long enough just to get past the first down marker to move the chain. So great play. Redding comes back out with the two receiver set this time. Number Trevor Conroy split right. Ball is on the ground again, kicked around. Pollock's going to have to pick that up, but he misses it. And this might be Wilmington's ball. Let's see what the ref says.
Got a flag too there, Brian. I think we might have jumped early. It looks like Wilmington's ball.
I don't know what's going on here, Joe. I'm trying to make sense of this whole thing. We do have a flag. I think Redding still retains the ball.
I have a feeling the penalty is on them.
On Wilmington?
On Redding.
It's on Redding.
That's a
10-yard penalty. That's got to be a hold.
Let's see. Get an indication from the referee here.
It's got to be a hold.
I didn't see one. Yep.
Hold?
I believe so, yes.
Got to be. Illegal kick. Can't kick the ball.
Oh, okay.
That's what it was. When Pollock went to bend down, he probably accidentally kicked it, resulting in a penalty.
Yeah, we got the ball. That's the key.
So Redding's got some ways to go here. We got about second and about 30 for the first down. Now we've got another false start. Redding continuing to go backwards. Very, very unfamiliar territory for the
Rockets
right now.
They look so sharp up to this point.
Yeah.
I mean, just a little lack of concentration.
Could be, yeah.
Looking at the scoreboard saying, let's go home, I don't know.
I don't know. Got to keep your head in it, boys, at least for another 4 minutes. All right, second and a long way to go as number 41.
Beckenhouse.
Sean Beckenhouse keeps the ball.
At this point, Brian, just try some things, use some clock.
Yeah, I think that's...
Avoid those penalties.
Probably a good thing.
Here comes Beckenhouse off.
Yep, number 41, Sean Beckenhouse checking out. Number 71,
Pat Dwyer
right. going left. I should know that by now, Pat.
Brandon Fox is in the slot to the left as well.
We've got motion with number 12, Dylan Lee. And the ball's on the ground, but picked up by Dom DiCosenza, who's trucking here. He's got some...
He is nifty.
He's got some moves for a big guy.
He does.
And he brings that ball. Everything they lost on those penalties, he just about gained right back. So
2 minute warning, Brian.
We're in a 2 minute warning. All right, at the 2 minute warning, which it appears they do stop the clock here.
Pop exactly Warner. 2 minutes.
Rockets have find themselves in a 4th and 5 situation with Dom DiCosenza trucking along, trying to get it, and it looks like he does get the first down. Nice hard run by Dom. He just laid that body out and got himself another 2 yards out of it when it looked like he was going to be tackled.
Mike Masucci going in for Lucas Fleming.
Yeah, number 23 Fleming checked out. Masucci checking in.
Let's see if Mike gets the ball. Anthony Masucci, I'm sorry. Yeah, it looks like he's set to get the ball. He had a great run last year, I remember, and lifted the team.
And he's got some room. He's got plenty of room, and he's going to take it. Number 65.
He's got an ability. I don't know.
Anthony Masucci. Big number 65. Anthony Masucci is able to get down there and do a great job. Gilligan? Okay, so after the score, Redding will come up for the extra attempt. With
it's like Joe Gilligan and
Dom DiCosenza, who's going to take it and get into the end zone for the extra attempt. Putting another point on the board, making Redding 34, Wilmington 6, with about a minute left in the game. All right, folks, well, that's the end of this game, the end of this contest, as Redding ends with a score of 34, Wilmington 6. A real good game. Both boys played hard. Wilmington came out.
I think it was a case Redding was very sharp early.
Yep.
Got a lead, and I just think it's a numbers game after that to Wilmington.
Yeah.
The kids played most of the game both ways. Redding kept shuttling substitutes in and out, and I think that was the difference.
Yeah, yeah, and that'll do it, especially the weather's getting a little bit warmer right now as the afternoon goes on, early September. That heat can get to you.
Yeah, give the Rockets credit, though. They came out very sharp for their first game.
Certainly did. They certainly did. Well, as we wrap it up here from Hollingsworth Field, we'll catch you next week.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.